Peminat teater Puteri Gunung Ledang The Musical sanggup melakukan apa saja semata-mata untuk bertemu dengan pelakon teater itu. Ada yang sanggup menunggu di depan komputer hanya untuk mendapatkan tiket awal secara online. Penat lelah itu berbaloi apabila 10 pembeli tiket istimewa diraikan dalam satu majlis makan malam.
Majlis makan malam itu dihoskan oleh pemeran watak Raden Ajeng Retno Demila, Datin Sri Tiara Jacqueline dan Datuk Laksmana Hang Tuah Stephen Rahman Hughes. 10 peminat bertuah dari pelbagai latar belakang bangsa berpeluang untuk mengenali dengan lebih dekat lagi dua pelakon itu yang selama ini hanya ditonton di pentas Istana Budaya. Majlis makan malam itu diadakan di Borneo Rainforest Sunway. Salah seorang peminat yang hadir, Sarah Carol, mengakui teater itu sangat berhantu. Dia bakal menonton teater itu di hari memperingati kekasih.
The first day I'm going to watch it is on Valentine's Day, and there's no better love story than Puteri Gunung Ledang. So I'm going to watch it the first another time on Valentine's Day, and I'm coming with my whole family the very next day. So I'm going to watch it 2 days in a row. So I queued up online and waited until the minute the site opened to make sure I got my tickets.
Produksi yang dihasilkan anak tempatan itu sangat hebat. Hinggakan lirik dan melodi lagunya terngiang-ngiang di kepala.
First, it is a production that every single Malaysian will be proud of. You know, when you go to see it, it is a Malaysian story. And the songs and the language is all in Bahasa. And it's something that just stirs up your emotions. And at the end of it, when you stand there, you are just so amazed at this amazing production and so proud that it's yours. Just so amazing. And why I think PGL gets under everybody's skin and all the people are here today is because 3-4 days after the production, you still think about it. 1 week later, you still remember the songs. 1 month later, you still think about the scenes. It stays in your head.
Alex Tan pula tidak sanggup melepaskan peluang untuk menonton teater musical yang sepatutnya tidak dilepaskan oleh semua rakyat Malaysia.
Memang satu musical yang berkualiti lah, yang boleh mengatakan Malaysia ni kita boleh buat show yang memang berkualiti. So this is one of the quality show that you shouldn't miss.
Sebagai peminat setia yang bakal menonton untuk kali ke-9, Muhammad Kamal Arifin berharap pementasan Februari depan lebih mengejutkan.
I would be expecting I think I would be expecting more good from the first two seasons, you know, something perhaps something different, you know, because I basically know and boleh hafal the storyline whatsoever, so perhaps, you know, certain props baru or certain scene yang lain, you know, yang more apa ni, lebih menarik lah.
Mereka turut dihiburkan dengan persembahan nyanyian dari Tiara dan Steve dengan lagu Keranamu Kekasih. Teater Puteri Gunung Ledang The Musical akan dipentaskan di Istana Budaya mulai 6 Februari tahun hadapan.
Stephen Rahman Hughes mengakui itulah kali pertama beliau melihat kembali lirik lagu Keranamu Kekasih setelah 2 tahun tidak melihatnya. Keterujaannya kembali memuncak dan terbayang-bayang di kotak mindanya persembahan yang pernah memukau rakyat Malaysia 2 tahun lalu.
Actually, because obviously, I mean, I've not sung that song for well over 2 years, and to see them there for the first time, I mean, actually, funnily enough, once I started singing the song, then I could remember this feelings, remember the show, you remember the lyrics. So yeah, it was really, really, really nice experience. And obviously to sing with Tiara again was really, really, really nice. And now all of a sudden I'm getting excited to come back in February and start working on the show.
Di United Kingdom, Steve dikenali dengan kumpulan Titro. Titro dikenali bukan sahaja di UK, tetapi juga di Afrika Selatan dan terkini album itu dipasarkan di Belgium. Tersimpan impian di hatinya untuk melebarkan sayapnya di sini. Sebagai permulaan, Titro bakal mengadakan persembahan di hadapannya di Pertuan Agong Mac tahun depan.
I mean, I've been talking to Teatro for a long time saying, look, you know, because you know, I've started a career in Malaysia and you know, it's really important and close to my heart, you know, the work that I do there. And, you know, so far, the work with Teatro has taken us all over the globe. We released in the UK straight away. You know, we were singing a huge televised concert, which with Bon Jovi and Seal and James Blunt, people like that. And the album, just straight from that performance, the album went to gold. And then from there, we released in South Africa. The album went to number one. And you know, already Malaysian fans on the internet were blogging and coming, getting in touch with me on Facebook and saying, you know, we want to see this album. When can we get this album in Malaysia? So I said to the record company, look, you know, we should definitely release in Malaysia. And there's plans to. The last thing we did was release in Belgium. So I think we're just working our way to this side of the planet. But sure enough, I mean, already there's plans for a concert in March for the King and Queen of Malaysia, for, you know, for the Agong, and just for us to come and perform for them, and, you know, for us to, for our first appearance in front of a Malay audience.